colonial period in the United States and in Brazil. So the reason I wrote this capstone, it is because I'm a Brazilian living in US, precisely. Because once I arrived here in US, I realized that we have many similarities between the two cultures, but also many differences. And it is interesting to see that each cause has a consequence. So the main idea of this capstone is not just to talk about the differences and to say, okay, so make a comparison, but also to show that if you have a choice and you practice this choice, we have a consequence in the life. And it happened also in the colonies. So if I want to make a propaganda of my capstone, there are two reasons why you should read my capstone. The first is because it is well written by myself, I hope. And the second, it is precisely to show that we have a choice in our hands and you need to do it. And how did I do that? Well, I divide my capstone in three chapters. The first chapter, I present the English colony. In other words, the American colonies, the 13 colonies. And I introduce, okay, so what the background was in England before the arrival of the Europeans in these lands. And then, okay, so what the causes also was when they arrived here. So what led the English to come here and to live here. And then the activities that was practiced were practiced here in these colonies. The second chapter, it is like similar to the first chapter, but referring to Brazil. So what the background was in Portugal, what the causes was, well, were in that led the Portuguese to come to go to Brazil and to live there, and also the activities that were practiced there. And the third chapter, it is the comparison. So making this comparison, I focused more on the differences rather than in the similarities, because I wanted to see, okay, so if we have many things similar, so what led us to become different cultures and countries nowadays? And the answer, it is mainly on the differences. So if I can give you some examples, the religion was one of the main causes, because as it is known, in England, they were Protestant, Anglicans, and at that time, they were persecuting all the other religions, in a way. And so all the Protestants, the Puritans, as they were called, came to live here, and they saw an opportunity to have a promised land here in the US. So everything was just grace and to let us build up a new empire of grace according to the gospel and to cultivate the land God has given us. Another hand, in Portugal, they were Catholics and the main idea was to evangelize. But also it is known that unfortunately the crown and the religion were two things different. So many times there were this conflict between the religion and the crown, because when the crown was trying to extract raw material, the Jesuits, they were trying to evangelize, and it brought a conflict. Also, the weather, the climate also was different, as it is now. I mean, we have experienced the non-Americans that here it is a little bit more cold, so we need to produce the land, like to take advantage of the time to produce and to make grow our food. So that's why there is this idea of always building and always trying to take advantage of the last minute also. In Brazil it is like, okay, it is warmer, we have more time to produce and to take our food, so we don't have that worry of being fed, because I mean the weather helps us there. And I hope you can read this capstone, because you can also take a book and read the whole book about the colonies and to see the difference of the two colonies. But I guess in my capstone it is like shorter and more summarized, so in order for the sake of the time, I guess it is also good